Hi, my name's Timothy Mountford, and under the supervision of Dr. Sheetal Sadal, myself and my close friend Darshal Ramchandra have spent the past year investigating the effect of vaccine hesitancy on the spread of measles through agent-based modeling. What does this mean, you might ask? Basically, it's looking at the effect of having anti-vaxxers in a city or a system and the way it affects the spread of measles. Well, what is agent-based modeling, you might ask? Well, it's an operations research simulation technique where individuals assess their situation and they make independent decisions depending on each of the different individuals. You might ask why this matters, and basically, it's because vaccine hesitancy, or the study of anti-vaxxers, is a relatively new field, and a lot of the information in the field tends to be presented with qualitative evidence, such as interviews with experts in the field and their explanations around the topic. And there is a lack of quantitative evidence to substantiate a lot of their claims. Here is where our simulation technique provides the ability to fill the gap in the field. So we decided to build a simulation of a small city with several different workplaces in CBDs or industrial areas, two different schools, recreational areas, and several suburbs. We then ran our simulation a good few times, with all the people moving between these areas and the children of non-anti-vaxxer parents taking their vaccines at appropriate ages according to vaccine coverage rates that have been input into the system. In the city, people who are really against taking vaccines make the people that they interact with a little bit more vaccine hesitant, as they tend to spread false information, where, as the disease grows, people tend to become less hesitant to take their vaccines as they learn more about the disease and start to fear it. We ran this simulation a whole lot of times, changing the amount of influence that the people who are really against vaccines have, and adjusting how much people start to fear the disease as it grows. We then collected information on every outbreak from each of these runs and did an analysis looking at the number of vaccines for the disease and the change in outbreak size, duration, and frequency when there were more anti-vaxxers in the system. We also compared the amount of influence the anti-vaxxers had and how much people were scared of the disease as it grew. But what we found was far from surprising. We found that as there were more anti-vaxxers in the city or the system, the outbreaks tended to be larger, last for longer periods of time, and happen more frequently. So if you take anything away from this, please vaccinate your kids.